Hello everyone, in this video we will make a simple but elegant looking chocolate butterscotch cake. This will turn out to be super soft, made in a kadhai without using any oven. So let's begin. To preheat our oven in a kadhai, we will keep a stand and keep this covered to preheat for 10 minutes on a low. For this cake, we will start by 3/4 cup of milk. This is warm milk, and in this we will add a tablespoon of vinegar. Mix this up and then we will keep this aside for a while. By the way, this is normal synthetic vinegar. Next, taking a bowl, add in 6 tablespoons of oil, any oil which is odor free. Over this we will drop 1/2 cup of powdered sugar. Mix sugar and oil together nicely with a whisk or using a spatula so that they get blended. Adding the side kept vinegar mixed milk, adding whole of it. You can do this job using a hand blender or even with a spatula or a spoon. Next, keeping a sieve, we need to sift all-purpose flour, that is maida. We have taken here 2 cups of all-purpose flour, that is also known as refined flour. Gradually add in, and then over this we will also add 1/2 cup of unsweetened cocoa powder along with 1/4 teaspoon of salt, a teaspoon of baking powder and 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. Sifting everything together ensures proper blending of the ingredients and also avoids any lumps. Our cup measurements are based on 250 ml of cup. We need to mix this to make a smooth lump-free batter for our cake. In this, little at a time, we will add 1 cup of milk. The milk should be at room temperature. We are almost done, but I forgot to add vanilla in this. So let's add 1 teaspoon of vanilla and then mix it again. And here the ribbon consistency batter is ready. This is 6.5-inch cake, mold lined and greased with the butter paper. The butter paper has been greased. Pour in the batter and then we will level it up. So the kadhai has already been preheated. Let's keep the cake mold in this. Bake the cake on medium for about 20 minutes and then lower the flame and bake it for about 50 to 60 minutes or till your toothpick comes out clean. Like, you can check the cake after 50 minutes. If it's not done, you can bake it for another 10 minutes. In the oven, you can bake it at 180 degrees centigrade for 40 to 45 minutes. Toothpick has come out clean. Cake is done. We will keep this covered until it cools down. To make the caramel frosting, we will make caramel. For this, in a pan we will add 1/2 cup of sugar. To make it quick, you can keep the heat over low to medium and continuously keep on stirring it until it melts completely. Make sure sugar doesn't burn, otherwise it will turn bitter. After the sugar completely melts, it will turn into a liquid, and at this point we will turn heat to a low, adding 25 grams of butter. This is salted butter. The butter should be at room temperature. Along with this, we will also add 100 ml of fresh cream. The cream should also be at room temperature. Keep on mixing and you will see that this has come to a boil. We will keep on boiling it for just a minute and then we will switch it off, because after it cools down, it will become much more thicker. After the caramel sauce comes down to room temperature, you can keep it in the refrigerator for 10 to 15 minutes to make it more thicker. Next, we have taken here cold whipping cream. This is about 250 ml of whipping cream. Whip it until stiff peaks. After the caramel sauce had come down to room temperature, we kept it in the refrigerator for about 15 minutes. And let's now add about 2 to 3 tablespoons of this in the cream. Mix and our frosting is ready. Time to assemble and decorate our cake. Let's remove the cover. It has come down to room temperature. We will unmold it and remove the butter paper. We will slice this cake into 2 halves, but it is big enough that you can make a 3-layer cake out of it. The top of the cake is almost flat. There is no dome over it, so we won't slice the cake on top. I have noticed the cake in the kadhai or a pressure cooker comes out to be very soft, and even the top part doesn't become too hard, provided you don't overbake it. Drop some frosting over your cake board so that the cake doesn't slip. Keeping the first layer of your cake, literally drench it with sugar syrup. Sugar syrup is made using 4 tablespoons of sugar boiled in 1/2 cup of water. Now drop the frosting and make a thick layer of the frosting. Taking the second layer, which is the top layer, we will pierce it using a toothpick so that it absorbs the sugar syrup. And then drop the frosting. Cover the whole cake with the frosting. Every time you level your frosting, clean your spatula or the scraper. Using a cake comb, we will make lines like this, vertical lines. Sprinkle some shredded chocolate over it. And some colorful sprinkles. Domino's inspired butterscotch cake is ready. I'm sure you will definitely try out this easy cake recipe. If you like the recipe, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up, like, share, comment, subscribe, hitting the bell icon. Till we meet again with another interesting recipe. Enjoy and bye-bye.